We'll discuss goodwill valuation, treatment of goodwill. Before that, we'll just work out two more problems under gaining ratio. Illustration number 11. You have to compute gaining ratio and new ratio. The information given to you, three partners, old proportions are given, not the ratio. Vikas retires and surrenders. Okay, just write Vikas share. Vikas share is 1 by 8 and he surrenders. They are mentioning about the sacrifice. He surrenders. The retiring partner will normally sacrifice. So Vikas surrenders 1 by 9 from his share in favor of Divya. That means what will be Divya's gain? He is sacrificing 1 by 9. Is it off his share? Off means you will have to do into 1 by 8. But it's not written off. It's written from. So 1 by 9 from his share. From his share means this Vikas share is given to Divya. So Divya is gaining 1 by 9. That is the meaning. Vikas is sacrificing 1 by 9 from his share in favor of Divya means Divya is gaining that. Indirectly they have mentioned the gaining proportion. Clear? So Divya's gain is 1 by 9 which is directly given. And the remaining in favor of Varun. Varun is the next partner. Varun's gain, this is Vikas. Vikas, not new share, he's a retiring partner. No? Vikas, old share. And Varun's gain means, it is written, the remaining is given to Varun. What is the remaining portion? Will you take 1 minus 1 by 9? No, because this 1 by 9 is the gaining proportion of Divya. This question and the previous question that we did, there are differences. Where it was mentioned 4 by 9th of our share is being given to Channi and then balance will be taken by or will be given to Mani. 4 by 9th of, there itself there is difference. It is of his share. Here it is from his share, we directly wrote 1 by 9 as Divya's gain. And how will you get Varun's gain? Can you do 1 minus 1 by 9? No, that is not the calculation. Can you do 1 minus 1 by 8? 1 minus 1 by 8 when you do, what are you getting? While you deduct Vikas share from the total portion 1, the balance is, if you do 1 minus 1 by 8, 8 minus 1, 7 by 8, this is the remaining portion of the other two, Divya and Varun. This is the remaining portion of Varun and Divya. What we need is Varun's gain. So we can't do all these. What we have to do is, Vikas is to be given 1 by 8. And for that, 1 by 9 will be taken from Divya. Vikas need 1 by 8. For this 1 by 8, 1 by 9 is being taken from Divya. So what will be the balance proportion or the balance share taken from Varu? That is the meaning of gaining proportion. So what will be the balance? How will you take the balance? It will be 1 by 8 minus 1 by 9. Understood? 1 by 8 minus 1 by 9. This is Varun's gain. Divya's gain we automatically wrote because it is written directly in the question. We just have to take and write. Now, what will be the other partner's gain? The retiring partner is 1 by 8. His share, out of his share, 1 by 9 is taken by Divya. So, what will be the balance taken by Varun? It will be 1 by 8 minus 1 by 9. This is the calculation. So, 1 by 8 minus 1 by 9. You can do cross multiplication. 9 minus 8, that is 1 by 72. So, the gaining ratio between Divya and Varun will be 1 by 9 is 2, 1 by 72. The base is different. So, make it to the common base. It will be 8 is to 1. The question is not over. We have to get the new ratio also. Yes, calculate new ratio also from this. So new ratio, now we can compute. The formula is gaining ratio plus old ratio. And for Divya, Divya's new share will be equal to, what is Divya's gaining share? Divya's gaining proportion you have to take, which is 1/9, plus Divya's old proportion you take from the question, it is 1/2. Do cross multiplication, it will be 11/18. Then the next partner, Varun. Varun's new share will be equal to, what is Varun's gaining proportion? Don't take gaining ratio, you have to take the proportion, that is 1/72, plus what is his old share? Varun's old share is 3/8. So here you can make the base as same, or you can do cross multiplication, both are correct. 27 + 1 = 28/72. Finally, the new ratio between Divya and Varun will be 11:2. Sorry, you have to now convert it into the common base. Okay, 28/72, or you can write it as 4/18. So now the base is same for these two. So new ratio between the partners will be 7/18. So 11:7. The new ratio between partners, now it is 11:7. So now we got the new ratio and the gaining ratio. Illustration 12. You have to do, I'll just explain because it is similar to what we did before. Three partners, Akash, Yogesh, Bhavesh, 4:3:1. Yogesh retires. The gaining ratio between Akash and Bhavesh is 4:5. But while you do calculation, can we directly take 4/9 as the gaining proportion? No. How will you take the gaining proportion of Akash? It will be 4/9 of Yogesh share. Yogesh share is 3/8. Understood? So you have to do 4/9 into 3/8. That is Akash gaining proportion. Don't simply write 4/9. Always you have to multiply it by the retiring partner's share. Now we'll discuss valuation and adjustment of goodwill. You give the heading valuation and adjustment of goodwill. It is similar to the previous chapter. And in this question, in this chapter, what will be the meaning of premium for goodwill? It is the reverse you have to write here. Premium for goodwill is the compensation given by remaining partners or continuing partners to whom? To the retiring partner, because the remaining partners will be gaining the retiring partner's share of profit. So that is the compensation given by remaining partners to the retiring partners, because the continuing or remaining partners will gain or will take the share of retiring partner or outgoing partner. That is the meaning of premium for goodwill in this chapter. Now, if you see a goodwill in the balance sheet, like in previous chapter, on asset side, if you see one goodwill here, okay, if you see one goodwill here, what will happen, what you have to do is just close this. Where you will take now, that will go to partner's capital. This is called goodwill appearing in the books. You need not write it again, already we have written in the chapter admission. So goodwill existing in the books. In the books means you will be having in the balance sheet. And how will you close partner's capital? To the opposite side you will close, to goodwill. You had this same question for your test paper. And what is the journal entry you have to write? Old partners. You can't simply write partner's capital debtor to goodwill. Specify them. It is old partner's capital debtor to goodwill. That is the journal entry, which you already know. Those who want can write it again, or else no need. Now in this chapter retirement, who are the old partners? A, B, C. Three people are there and three will be old partners. And so we can write it as old partners also. In chapter retirement, all and old, A-L-L and O-L-D will be C, because all three are old partners. Clear? So you can either write it as old partners or OLD also, correct. Old partners, capital, debtor to goodwill. And in which ratio? When you say old partners, this must be in old ratio. So we didn't study anything new. It's the same like admission chapter. Next is, when goodwill does not exist in the books. Second situation, this is when goodwill exists in the books, in the balance sheet. Next is, goodwill does not exist in the books. And do you all know two types of goodwill? We have self-generated goodwill and at the same time we have purchased goodwill also. Two types of goodwill, that is self-generated goodwill and purchased goodwill. Among these two, only purchased goodwill will be recorded in the books. Purchase. Now you will have a question like, how we can purchase a goodwill. Last in 11th standard, we have discussed this, how you can purchase a goodwill. Suppose you are taking over other business. You took over other business, that is A Limited. You took over this A Limited and you will have to pay something. When you are taking over their business, you will have to pay something. That is rupees 20 lakhs. Suppose you paid rupees 20 lakhs when you took over A. And this 20 lakhs, this calculation is done based on this. How you will ascertain the amount you have to pay A Limited? This is how you are computing. You will take their assets, you will take their liabilities, you will find the difference. A minus L, assets minus liabilities you will do. And now you got, after computing this, you got 20 lakhs. This is the amount you have to pay A Limited. This is called purchase consideration. The amount you have to pay the firm, the other firm, when you take over their firm. That amount is called purchase consideration. And here purchase consideration is 20 lakhs. We computed by using this formula. But instead of 20 lakhs, you paid an extra amount, that is 25 lakhs. Why an extra amount? That extra amount is for their goodwill, for their reputation. So what you pay in excess of net worth, net worth means A minus L, what you pay in excess of that, that difference will be the 25 minus 20, 5 lakhs will be the value of purchased goodwill. Here we are purchasing it. Understood? It's being taken over from other firm. It's purchased goodwill. It can be expressed in monetary terms. You can say there is goodwill of 5 lakhs. Only purchased goodwill will be recorded in the books of the firm. While you see the balance sheet, if you can find on the asset side one goodwill, that is always purchased goodwill, that you must know. Then there is something called a self-generated goodwill. Self-generated means it is earned with the efforts of their own employees. And such generated, self-generated goodwill will not be shown in the books because it cannot be expressed in money terms. We know that this is a limitation. Last year we have learnt limitations of accounting. Only monetary items will be recorded. So this self-generated goodwill will not be recorded in the books. So I just explained two types of goodwill. Okay, coming back to the portion, goodwill does not exist in the books. In the balance sheet, we don't have a goodwill, but as an adjustment, they will write. Last chapter also, we had in your adjustment, goodwill of the firm valued so much, or the premium for goodwill brought in by the new partner is so much. So other than balance sheet goodwill, we have in the adjustment also. So that's what we are discussing now, when goodwill does not exist in the books. And what is premium for goodwill? We discussed the meaning was, it is paid by A and C to B because they are gaining B's share, the retiring partner's share. And the journal entry for goodwill in this case, in the first situation, you write the heading when goodwill account is not opened. When goodwill account is not opened. Now we are talking about goodwill in the adjustment, that is the premium for goodwill to be paid to the retiring partner. So to whom we are paying? To retiring partner we are paying. So we will write to retiring partners capital, or if it is fixed capital you must write it as current account. So to retiring partners capital or current account, and who will pay them? The other two, A and C, will pay them. They should be now termed as gaining partners, because they are continuing partners, or they can be called as remaining partners. Now why we are debiting them? Because they are gaining the retiring partner's share. So now they should be termed as gaining partners. So what is the basic journal entry for goodwill in this chapter? This is the goodwill in the adjustment. Goodwill in the balance sheet, there is no change. This is the goodwill in the adjustment. Last chapter we had different cases. When he is brought in kind, when he is unable to bring, when he brings and then withdrawn by the partners. We have different cases of premium for goodwill. Here we have only this basic journal entry. You just have to study this basic entry of goodwill. That is, gaining partners will be paying the retiring partner. So to retiring partner, and what you have to debit is mention them as gaining partners, because they are gaining this partner's share, and so the ratio must be gaining ratio. In previous chapter, premium for goodwill ratio we divided in sacrificing. Instead of that, here it is gaining. That's only difference. And gaining ratio is no, new ratio minus old ratio. So under this case 2, this is subheading 1. When goodwill is not opened, you just have to write this basic entry. This will be the entry you will be doing in most of the questions. Now we have two more cases under this case 2. Two more subheads are there. Write when goodwill, what we wrote now is goodwill account is not opened. So now it is when goodwill account is opened at its current value or full value. Goodwill account is opened at its current value or full value. So basically, while you cancel, you will be again getting the basic entry. Gaining partner to retiring, only that one basic entry you need to remember in this chapter. But if they ask you to specifically open goodwill account, there is a slight change in that entry. You have to first open goodwill, then they will ask you to write it off. So how will you open a goodwill? Open goodwill means no need to prepare any ledger. In the journal entry you have to show that. So while you open goodwill, goodwill basically it is an asset. So while you open it, it must be debited. Goodwill account debtor, and this goodwill is earned with the efforts of all three partners. So we'll write it as goodwill account debtor to, it must be given to all three, all partners capital or current account depending on the question. And in which ratio? When you say all partners, there is no confusion, it must be in their old ratio. So goodwill account debtor to all partners capital account, that's the first entry. Now when you opened goodwill, later what you have to do is you have to write off goodwill. After opening the goodwill, you will have to write it off. Writing off means you have to cancel it. So while you cancel, the debited goodwill now will be credited. So we'll write to goodwill, and this cancellation takes place after retirement of the partner B. So now we can debit only the remaining partners, only the continuing partners. So we have to write continuing partners capital account debtor to goodwill. Continuing partners capital account debtor to goodwill, and in which ratio you have to do? In the new ratio, because now B is not there, and this must be shared between A and C in their new ratio. So what did we do? We opened goodwill, and this goodwill is due to the efforts of all three. So we gave to all partners. Then next step is writing off the cancellation. We credited the goodwill for cancelling, and what we can debit is the continuing partners, because this is done after retirement of partner B. So we can debit only continuing partners A and C, and that must be taken in their new ratio. We'll work out one question, and I will show you when you cancel this entry, again you will be getting the basic entry. What is the basic entry? I told you, gaining partner, debtor to retiring partner. Everywhere you will be getting the basic entry. Only thing is, we opened goodwill, then we cancelled. Now goodwill will get cancelled actually. Then the remaining what you get will be gaining partner, debtor to retiring partner. I will show you how it is. Illustration number 1. I mean, illustration number 1 means it is given on page number 6.11. Within a box, we have illustration 1. This is not the very first question. So, page number 6.11, illustration 1. Yes, three partners are there. Their ratio is given. Akhil is retiring from the firm. On which date goodwill of the firm is given. So, you have to get what is Akhil's share. Don't simply write goodwill of the firm in the question. Pass necessary journal entries giving effect to goodwill on Akhil's retirement. Raising goodwill at its current value. Did you see that last sentence? You have to give effect to goodwill. If the question is over with that word, what will be your answer? The basic entry, gaining partner, debtor to retiring partner. Here, we can't write the basic entry because they have asked you to raise goodwill. And it is understood that though they don't ask you to write off goodwill, you must write off. Because that goodwill is earned with the efforts of all three. Now, after retirement, it is the new firm. You have to cancel that particular goodwill. So, this question we have to write by opening and then cancelling goodwill. This method it is. And it is written, you have to open at its current value or full value. So, these two journal entries we have to write. So, what's the first entry? Goodwill debtor to old partners. Here, old partners Amit, Amrit, Akhil. So, we'll write goodwill account debtor to Amit, Amrit, Akhil. Amit's capital to Amrit's capital and to Akhil's capital. And how will you take the amount? Goodwill is taken at its full value. So, entire 1,20,000 you can take. Okay. Entire 1,20,000 will be divided because it's taken at its full value or current value. So, 1,20,000 we will divide in the old ratio. Old ratio is 3:2:1 directly there in the question. So, you will get the answer as 60, 40, 20. Draw the format and do. Just draw the format and do. I forgot to draw the format. Okay, that is goodwill distributed to all the partners in old ratio, the narration. Later what you have to do is cancellation. At the time of cancellation, who will be debited? Only the continuing partners. Here the continuing partners are Amit and Amrit. So you write Amit's capital debtor. Amit is the first one, right? Yeah. Amit's capital debtor, Amrit's capital debtor to goodwill. We are cancelling. Don't copy the same figures because your ratio is different. You have to divide it in their new ratio. What is the new ratio between the partners? Okay, new ratio between partners not given. What will you do? Remember, this is chapter admission. This is chapter retirement. And what you have to do is just strike off. 3:2:1. Who is the retiring partner? Akhil is the retiring partner. So, the new ratio will be 3:2. No other calculation. So, 3:2 is the new ratio. That 1,20,000 you have to take in the new ratio. Don't simply copy from the previous entry. So now 3:2 is the new ratio and the division will be 72 and 48. Just see these two journal entries. Amit's capital and Amrit's capital debited and credited, but with different amounts. If you cancel and take the amounts, just do it and see the final entry, the resultant entry, what you get will be gaining partner's capital debtor to retiring partner's capital. So again, we'll reach at the basic entry. Everywhere it's a basic entry you are recording. But in case the question asks you to open goodwill, that too at its current value, this is how you have to write. Open it, then write it off. But again, finally the answer will be gaining partner to retiring partner. No need to write the resultant entry. You must write these two entries separately itself if they ask you to open goodwill. The same type of question can be asked in the chapter admission also. There also the same thing you have to do. No change. If they ask you to open goodwill at its current value, what will you do? These two entries must be written in that chapter also. No difference. Then, subhead number 3, case 2, subhead 3, that is when goodwill account is opened, goodwill account is opened only to the extent of retiring partner's share, that means not at its full value. Only to the extent of retiring partner's share. If this is the case, the first journal entry, again you have to open goodwill. So goodwill account debtor to, you are opening only to the extent of retiring partner's share. So can you write two alt partners? No. Instead of that, now it is only for retiring partners. There it was full value, so we gave to all three. Now it is to be opened only to the extent of retiring partners, so we have to write like this. Then next is cancellation. So goodwill now will be credited. Now what will be debited? Instead of continuing partners, in this case, what we have to debit is when you say retiring partner, who is paying the retiring partner? The gaining partners. So you must write gaining partners capital account debtor to goodwill. And in which ratio you will take this? You must take, whenever you mention them as gaining partners, it must be in gaining ratio. Don't write continuing partners, don't take new ratio. Here there is difference. We are opening only to the extent of retiring partners share, and while you cancel, who is paying them? When you mention retiring partner, it will be the gaining partners who pays them. So in the gaining ratio, you have to divide. See the final entry, the resultant entry, goodwill will get cancelled. The resultant entry again is gaining partners capital debtor to retiring partners capital. You must work out illustration 2 based on this. Do that question in your notebook. You just have to apply this entry. Understood? Here, be careful. Take it in the gaining ratio. And here, goodwill account debtor to retiring partner, while you write illustration 2, goodwill of the firm is 1,20,000. But will you write entire 1,20,000? No, here we are opening only to the extent of retiring partner's share. So what will you do? 1,20,000 into what is retiring partner's share is 1/6. That is 20,000 in the journal entry. What you have to write is only 20,000. Write their names there. To who is the retiring? Raman. Raman's capital account you have to write. Then next one, gaining partner's debtor. For that you need to compute the gaining ratio. Clear? So this is how you have to do that illustration 2 given on page number 6.12. Page 6.12.